Hi everybody, today is March 10th, 2013. Afghan leader alleges U.S. treachery. Afghan President Hamid Karzai on Sunday accused the Taliban and the United States of working in concert to convince Afghans that violence will worsen if most foreign troops leave, an allegation top American commander in Afghanistan rejected as categorically false. Karzai said two suicide bombings that killed 19 people on Saturday, one outside the Afghan Defense Ministry and the other near a police checkpoint in Eastern Kosht province, show the insurgent group is conducting attack to help show that international forces will still be needed to keep the peace after the current combat mission ends in 2014. The explosions in Kabul and Kosht yesterday show that they are at the service of America, and at the service of this phrase, 2014. They are trying to frighten us into thinking that if foreign troops are not in Afghanistan, we'll be facing these sorts of incidents, he said during a nationally televised speech about the state of Afghan women. U.S. and NATO force commander General Joseph Dunford said Karzai had never expressed such a view to him, but said it was understandable that tensions would arise as the coalition balances the need to complete its mission and the Afghans move to exercise more sovereignty. We have fought too hard over the past 12 years. We have shed too much blood over the past 12 years to even think that violence or instability would be to our advantage, Dunford said. Karzai is known for making incendiary comments in his public speeches, a move that is often attributed to him trying to appeal to those who sympathize with the Taliban, or as a way to gain leverage when he feels his international allies are ignoring his country's sovereignty. In previous speeches, he has threatened to join the Taliban and called his NATO allies occupiers who want to plunder Afghanistan's resources. Karzai also denounced the arrest of the university student Saturday by Afghan forces his aide said were working for the CIA. It is unclear why the student was detained. Presidential spokesman Emil Fazari said that the CIA freed the student after Karzai's staff intervened, but that Karzai wants the Afghan raiders arrested. The president issued a decree on Sunday banning all foreign forces from universities and schools unless they obtain prior permission from the Afghan government. The Karzai government latest comments and actions come as it negotiates a pact with the U.S. for the long-term presence of American forces in Afghanistan, and just days after an agreement to transfer the U.S. prison outside of Kabul to Afghanistan authorities fell through. They also came during Defense Secretary Chuck Hagel's first visit to Afghanistan since becoming the Pentagon's chief. Karzai said in his speech that any foreign powers that want to keep troops in Afghanistan need to do so under conditions set forward by Afghanistan. We will tell them where we need them and under which conditions. They must respect our laws. They must respect the national sovereignty of our country and must respect all our customs, Karzai said. Karzai offered no proof of coordination, but he said the Taliban and the United States were in daily negotiations in various foreign countries and noted that the United States has said that it no longer considers the insurgent group its enemy. The U.S. continues to fight against the Taliban and other militant groups, but has expressed its backing for formal peace talks with the Taliban to find a political resolution to the war. Karzai said he did not believe the Taliban's claim that they launched Saturday's attack to show they are still a potent force fighting the United States. Yesterday's explosion, which the Taliban claimed, showed that in reality they are saying they want the presence of foreigners in Afghanistan, Karzai said. In the arrest of the college student, Karzai said the raiders fired shots as they grabbed the student Saturday from the Kandahar University and blindfolded him before taking him for negotiations at a CIA post that Taliban leader Mullah Omar once used as a home. The CIA could not be reached for comment. The CIA has trained an Afghan counter-terrorist force, several thousand strong, known as the Counter-Terrorism Pursuit Team, that works mostly in insurgent strongholds in southern and eastern Afghanistan. U.S. officials say they work with the Afghan intelligence service, but Karzai frequently complains he lacks oversight over their operations. And I am sure he is correct about the United States working with the Taliban. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.